For about 4 years, I've wanted to make the world's smallest Nerf gun, because I have the world record for the world's largest. I knew I wanted to use like nanotechnology, and I needed to go to the school that was kind of the cutting edge that led in this field. It just so happens that was my alma mater, BYU. Found Dr. Howe, who taught me when I was here. I said, I've got this banger idea for this video, but we're gonna need to make these really, really, really tiny Nerf guns.
My first thought was, this is going to be a very fun engineering project. Although we've done projects like deploying solar panels in space with NASA and making medical implants that reduce patients' pain, we've never done anything like building something to launch a projectile, especially at the microscopic scale.
Larry contacted me and said, you're the expert on making tiny things, so I'd like you to be part of the conversation.
This is really important when you get really small. You can't assemble these things, and you can't have a bunch of different moving parts. So it needs to be made out of just one piece. Nothing makes sense more than using a compliant mechanism. Like, we could not have remotely done what we wanted to do without using compliant mechanisms.
To understand compliant mechanisms, think of origami. It's one piece of paper that then folds up, gets all of that complex motion, but with no hinges, no bearings, no assembly, just one piece of material.
So we made a one-to-one size fireable Nerf gun out of one piece, again, using the expertise of all the legends over there in the BYU engineering department. And then we made one that was 10 times smaller. We called that our medium size. And then we made one that was even 10 times smaller than that. And that one's like two flecks of pepper. It's tiny. But it's an actual functioning, firing Nerf gun, which is so delightful.
It's fun to kind of show the proportions here and just to really show the scale of how small these actually are.
It wasn't easy. Anytime that you're doing something that has never been done before, there are going to be challenges that you don't anticipate.
The most difficult part was trying to understand how we could take one of these tiny little Nerf guns and hold it still so that we could pull back the shuttle and arm it.
Up until, you know, even a few weeks before we actually filmed with Mark, we never actually fired one of these at the small scale. And that was really nerve-wracking.
Dr. Howell came into our conference area and he was urging us, he said, pray that it will work out, because I know it'll work out, but if we have faith and we seek inspiration, not only will this work, but it will work so much better than we would even imagine.
First time we saw that we could pull the trigger and actually the dart disappeared from frame, that was a very rewarding time to see that happen.
Yes, I just kind of, you know, pumped my fist and kind of gave high fives all around.
The fact that we could actually like load it back and actually have the compliant mechanism like hit the dart and have it fire next to an ant, and the ant is like gargantuan compared to this thing. Completely surprising, delightful, amazing, lovely, all the superlatives.
The best part of this project was to be able to provide opportunities for students to do something that's never been done before and have it viewed by tens of millions of people.
This is a bit of a ridiculous application for making the world's smallest Nerf gun and getting that world record, but you can imagine if you can make a Nerf gun, all the practical, awesome things that could be made with the same technology.
Here's, you know, one of the most famous engineers in the world, right, coming to the lab and working with the students, and they got to interact with him. It was everything we had hoped for.
The students that we worked with have just been incredible. I mean, you'd expect nothing less from the kind of engineering students that BYU produces.